I'm not sure if it's Black History Month or the whole BLM movement, but whatever it is, keep sending these movies out because I'm here for all of it. So Judas and the Black Messiah is a movie about a guy infiltrating a chapter of the Black Panthers in order to bring them down because he's messed up and the FBI is kind of telling him either you help us or you're going to jail for quite a bit of time. And even though I understand saving yourself, come on, man. Now, that's really all I can say about the plot without ruining too much of the movie. But Lakeith Stanfield plays the character of William O'Neill, who's the guy who infiltrates the Black Panthers. And Daniel Kaluuya plays Fred Hampton, who's the leader of the chapter or the chairman. Now, starting out, I gotta say, I actually like Daniel Kaluuya in this role because I know him mostly from Get Out. And in that role, he had like this smooth, suave, charismatic personality about him when he was navigating that white world that he was in. And he brought that charisma to this role as well because I believed him as a Black movement leader. Now, the antagonist in this movie, or one of the main antagonists, is played by Lakeith Stanfield, who plays William O'Neill, like I mentioned earlier. And I gotta say, I was shocked to see this role because, first off, he was also in Get Out. He was the one who was who came up to Daniel Kaluuya and was like, "Get out, man! Get out, man!" But anyway, I was shocked to see him in this role because I see him as an up-and-coming actor. I really do. I can't name off the top of my head everything that he's been in, but every time I see him on screen, I'm like, hey, he did a good job in that role. And even though he did a great job as William O'Neill in this movie, because he was kind of torn between, like, okay, do I do this to keep myself out of jail, or do I start believing in this movement because they're making some good points and they're out to help me? And that's why I was shocked that he took the role, because normally when you have certain actors, they refuse to take certain roles because the role can follow them in their career or it can ruin their career. And when I saw him playing his role, the Uncle Tom, I figured that that could be something that could be damaging in the Hollywood world. But maybe I'm wrong. Only time will tell. So Jesse Plemons is the FBI agent who's handling Lakeith's character, and he's kind of like his contact. And I gotta say, I believed his role as a racist white guy. And even though he wasn't like openly, blatantly racist, and there were conversations in the movie that made you feel like maybe he's not just racist, maybe he just is doing his job. But either way, I think he did a great job in here too. The pacing of the movie was kind of an issue for me. It's a 2-hour movie, which is kind of the norm now, but it just wasn't filled to the brim with excitement because it's not an action movie. So you do catch yourself sometimes, you know, like, how much longer do I got in this movie? But I think that they did well enough with the character development and the dialogue that it does keep you engaged enough where you're not just constantly watching the clock waiting for it to end. And even though you can kind of tell where this movie is going, even based off the title, I mean, Judas and the Black Messiah, the movie isn't all negative. I did like how they showed the Black Panther Party being positive. Like, Daniel Kaluuya's character was not a violent guy. And normally when you see these kind of roles where they're like bringing a black activist or something like that, they typically either make them violent and angry or they kill them. And it's mainly due to Daniel Kaluuya because, like, there are times where stuff is about to hit the fan and he's a cool, calm, collected, charismatic dude, and he kind of sways everything and calms stuff down. And I really enjoyed that because typically when you hear about the Black Panthers, you hear about them being a problem and the FBI killing them. And even though some of that happens in this movie, I did like that they shined a positive light on the Panther Party. To sum it up, I think Judas and the Black Messiah is a good watch. It has great acting in it. It has decent pace, and it's a very informative movie. And it's Black History Month, so why not? So with all that being said, I'd have to say that this is a midday matinee. All right, so that's it for this one, folks. So for the comment combo today, I want you to tell me, what do you think about Lakeith's role if you've seen this movie? Would you have done it, or would you have skipped this role in light of a role that showed you in a better light? Whatever you think, comment below and let me know. Now, as always, if you liked this video and you thought it rocked, like, comment, subscribe to see more from me, Mike Propp. Later.